Talk about your buddy. I know you addressed it on your show the other day, Boomer Esiason.
Yeah.
The chemistry you had for him. I mean, you're 10 years every morning with the guy. You know, you bring your life into the studio. You talk your buddy around. You go to games. Talk about that relationship and how the separation has been hard for you.
Listen, you go from having, like you said, we spent more time together than we do with our own families. I was there at 4. He was there at 5:30. But, you know, for 5, 6, 7 hours a day, appearances together, going places together, vacations together, shows together for 10 years. And then to have that just really ripped away from both of us is very difficult. And I think, because of my legal situation, I think Boomer was put in a very uncomfortable situation because here's someone in me that he adores and loves, and we have a great relationship. And then all of a sudden it was, well, how do you carry on that relationship? Do you go out to dinner 3 days later? I don't know that you do. I think he was very respectful of trying to give me space to figure stuff out on my own and with my family. And I think for him, and we've not talked about it, we will, I'm sure, one day, I think he wasn't sure what's the best way for me to be a friend. He was great publicly. Said everything you could ever ask a partner to say publicly. We played golf together a couple weeks ago, which I didn't want to talk about, but I brought up on the show because a caller asked about it. But I think if you talk to Boomer, he would tell you he wants the best for me. If there was an opportunity for us to work again, with all due respect to Greg and what he's doing, I think he'd love to. And we had something, that clearly was very special. For me to come back in this manner and to have a lot of people want to hear it, and people ask him every day and ask me every day about Boomer and Carton, it speaks volumes about what the show was. And I tell people all the time, I miss the show dearly. And if there was a chance to somehow do that and also do this, that'd be great. But I certainly miss it a great deal.
He kind of became the spokesman because people were asking him questions. It became page 6.
Yeah,
of the New York
he knew
Post.
He knows nothing about it. Unfortunately, no one does. So he was put in a spot where, what'd you know? How's Craig? Or what did he do? What didn't he do? And what's the answer? I don't know. So I think he was put in an awkward position. But like I said, we played golf a couple weeks ago, and he and I seemed to be fine. And that's all I want. I'm sure that's all he wants.